open thou our lips.
And our mouth shall show forth thy praise.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah, chapter 14, beginning at verse 13. Then I said, Ah, Lord God, Here are the prophets saying to them, you shall not see the sword, nor shall you have famine, but I will give you true peace in this place. And the Lord said to me, the prophets are prophesying lies in my name. I did not send them, nor did I command them or speak to them. They are prophesying to you a lying vision, worthless divination, and the deceit of their own minds. Therefore, thus says the Lord concerning the prophets who prophesy in my name, though I did not send them, and who say, sword and famine shall not come on this land. By sword and famine those prophets shall be consumed. And the people to whom they prophesy shall be thrown out into the streets of Jerusalem, victims of famine and sword. There shall be no one to bury them, themselves, their wives, their sons, and their daughters. For I will pour out their wickedness upon them. You shall say to them this word, let my eyes run down with tears night and day, and let them not cease. For the virgin daughter, my people, is struck down with a crushing blow, with a very grievous wound. If I go out into the field, look, those killed by the sword. And if I enter the city, look, those sick with famine. For both prophet and priest ply their trade throughout the land and have no knowledge. Here ends the first reading. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians in chapter 5, beginning at verse 1. Therefore be imitators of God as beloved children, and live in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. But fornication and impurity of any kind, or greed, must not even be mentioned among you, as is proper among saints. Entirely out of place is obscene, silly, and vulgar talk. But instead, let there be thanksgiving. Be sure of this, that no fornicator, or impure person, or one who is greedy, that is, an idolater, has any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. Let no one deceive you with empty words, for because of these things the wrath of God comes on those who are disobedient. Here ends the second reading.
Thank you.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, which art in
mercy upon us.
And grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the Queen.
And mercifully hear us when we call upon thee.
Endue thy ministers with righteousness. Save thy people.
And bless thy inheritance.
Give peace in our time, O Lord.
Because there is none other.
God, make clean our hearts within us.
And take not thy Holy Spirit from us.
O God, O declarest thy almighty power, most chiefly in showing mercy and pity. Mercifully grant unto us such a measure of thy grace, that we, running the way of thy commandments, may obtain thy gracious promises, and be made partakers of thy heavenly treasure. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Saviour. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Let us pray. At a time of crisis, Jeremiah demanded truthful speech in public life. Almighty God, from whom alone is lawful authority among the nations, give to their leaders and rulers today such concern for those entrusted to their care and such regard for the common good that they may speak the truth, however hard to hear, and do the right, however great the cost, that together we may face the challenges of this time, bound together in trust, with a common purpose in hope, and responsible for one another in love. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. St. Paul called the Christian community to wholesome speech and purity of life. Heavenly Father, you have shown us your will in the life and death of your Son. Give us grace to follow him in all the ways of love, in compassion for those who suffer, and in the redress of injustice, with words of truth on our lips and purity of motive in our hearts, at the service of all who need our care, and with respect to each as made in your image. So may we prove ourselves citizens of the kingdom, established by your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. A prayer for musicians. God, our Creator, in music we express joy beyond description, pain past bearing, and grief beyond words. We pray for those who cannot use the gift while performance is prevented, gathering restricted, and audience impossible. Especially we remember those who are employed in the service of your church. Provide for their livelihood, relieve their need, and sustain their spirit, and hasten the time when, in confidence and safety, voices and instruments can again sound your praise and give heart and life to all who hear. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Thank you.
God the Father, the heartbeat of the universe, lead you in wisdom and truth.
Amen.
God the Son, the melody of love, perfect in you the song of his kingdom.
Amen.
God the Holy Spirit, the harmony of the world, order your life in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen.